Hello everyone. Today we'll be seeing about conditions and interactive scripts. And in this session we'll discuss on if condition and case clauses. Case is one of the clause just like if. As most of you have seen if in most of the basic languages like C, C++ during your engineering course. In if, you give a comparison or command, and if that falls true, in here if you see, it will test the test command, and if it falls true, then the consequent commands will be executed. Similarly, here if these conditions are true, then do something will be executed. And double brackets are used to enclose the conditional expressions. If clause also has else in it. This is a very, very simple syntax, but it has also else in it, where if the test command is false, then else clause will be executed. One more thing also you need to remember is in shell scripting, these clauses, if the way it starts, it ends in the reverse way. Means here it's starting with if, so, and it ends with fi. Similarly, for case statements also, it ends with case, then esac, esac. Next, let us go to the primary expressions. So, in primary expressions, let us take the example of test, of this test command. In this test command, whatever you want to actually compare, there are multiple expressions which can be used. Like, hyphen E is for if file is. Hyphen F is for if the file exists and it is a regular file. Then file is not equal to, file 1 is not equal to file 2. File 1 is older than file 2. File 1 is less than equal to inode number of file 2. Similarly, string 1 equals to 2, string 2 means comparing the two strings. This one for not equal to. So let us go through some of the examples to know more regarding the expressions. So let us go ahead with these examples. Let us go to the scripting directory. So we are in the scripting directory. And let us create this file first. I'll just copy it. And let me cat the file. So what it is doing, as I told earlier, it will be executed in bash shell script, bash shell. And the first command it will be writing is, this script checks the existence of the messages file. So what it will do, then it will also throw a output as check-in. Then if hyphen f var log messages exist. So what is this hyphen f stands for? Let us go back to our primary expressions. So if you go through these expressions, you can see hyphen f stands for it's true if file exists and is a regular file. So it should be a regular file. In hyphen a, it will just check for a file. In hyphen b, it will check for a file also whether it is a block special file. Similarly, for hyphen c, it should be a character special file and it should exist. Hyphen d, if true if file exists and is a directory. Likewise, you can see, so here we are using the option hyphen f. So if while log messages exist, then echo this one exists, and if it does not, then does not exist. Then I will close my if statement, and then I'll give a gap in here with echo, and then I'll print the output as done. So let me run this. I'll simply run it like this. You can see, as I told you, the first statement, it will be throwing the output, then checking, then it saw, then the if clause starts, and it is, and since the if clause is there, it is throwing the output like this. One more thing you can do in here is, in here it is exists like that, it's showing. So let us see, let us edit the file first. And let me change the name. So currently, var log message e is missing from here. So this file does not exist. So let me run it around. It's saying it does not exist. Also, this is just, we are showing you in here how the if statement works. If statement is not only for throwing you the output like it, this file exists or this file does not exist. You can give multiple things in here, like let me edit it again. And in here, cat so the permission is coming as permission denied because I'm doing it from root from Oracle. So I need to log in as root user to run this. And let me run it now. You can see it ran, and after that it gave a space and done. So what was my script? My script was cat var log messages. So I am just taking the output from there. That's it. Next, let us go to our next example as per our document. And the next is no clobber. Here hyphen O is the option name, and the option name we are given in here is no clobber, which checks whether the file is protected against accidental overwriting using redirection. So if you simply run it, it won't give any output since you aren't running it inside a script. Next, testing exist status with if. So what will it do is, so dollar question mark value will be zero if your query exists successfully. So if your dollar question mark is equals to zero, then earlier command executed successfully. Else, earlier command did not execute successfully. So let me run this. So it came that it ran successfully because my dollar question mark value is zero. See in here, I just gave dollar question mark. So it said that command not found. That's why right now it is saying that earlier command did not execute successfully. Now we can also do like this. If we run this, what will be the output? If not grep oracle etc password. So if in etc password oracle user is there, is not there, then user does not exist, else user exists. So we will get the output as user exists in here. Similarly, if we give the statement as this, since it was a does not exist, then only it will be coming in here. So in here I am giving the statement as user exists at first, else user does not exist, then close the. So we are getting the output. Next, let us work with numerics and give the value. See, in let us cat revenues. So in revenues we have four statements. So cat, you can see like this, four rows are there. So I'll give the value of num equals to 4. So if you do echo dollar num, my value is 4. Then if I run this, if dollar num is greater than 4, then condition is true, else condition is false. So in here what will be the output for us? Num value is 4, so the output should be condition is false. So in here if you change the value as then echo, I'll give a space, else echo is false. A5, you can see it gave a space, then echo condition is true. And here there was no space provided, so it gave the output in here like this. Next, let me go ahead with one more example. In here let me give the num value as 13, num equals to 13. Then let me run this. This goes with our syntax with double brackets. So we are trying to, let's execute this with num value as 13. So if dollar num is equal to 12, num is actually equal to 12, or else num is not 12. So in here we will give the or get the output as num is not 12. Similarly, if you give in here, if num is greater than 12, and let us see, you need to make sure that you give a space between this, between the brackets and what you write, whatever you write. Else equal num is not greater than 12, A5. So num is actually greater than 12. So in here we saw equals to and greater than expression. So with the num variable. Next, let us go to our activity where we already saw this. And who am I? This thing you need to remember, that if you go through expansion section in our previous sessions, if anything is in between dollar and braces, the command will be executed on the command line console and the value will be pulled in dollar. Also, dollar zero states in which bash you're running. So in here, what it will be doing, if I will just paste it in here, let me clear the screen. So what it is doing, if dollar who am I is not equal to root, then echo you have no permission to run bash or the shell as non-root user. Else echo welcome, then fi. So because right now I'm logged in as root user, so let me go back to Oracle user and run the script again. So right now I'm in my Oracle user. I'll just copy and paste it. You have no permission to run bash as non-root user. So this explains about our some string comparisons with if. Next comes double pipes or logical statement. So here what we'll do is, we need to give a value of A, and then it in this statement it will state if dollar A is less than 25 or double pipe is or dollar A is greater than 50, then the value of dollar A either less than 25 or greater than 50, else the value of dollar A is between 25 and 50. So let me give the value of A first as 34 and run this. Well, there's some syntax error. As you can see in here, hyphen gt. Let me see whether it runs or not. Yes, there was some syntax error in there. Then what we need to do is, then echo the value of dollar A is either less than 25 or greater than 50, else echo the value of dollar A is between 25 and 50. So it executed this one. Similarly, if I give the value of A is A as and execute the query again, the value of dollar A, which is 112, is either less than 25 or greater than 50. Since it is greater than 50, that's why it came in here. This query got executed. In the previous one, this query got executed because it is between 25 and 50. Let's go to our advanced if usage. Here, we'll be seeing how we can pass an argument value and execute some queries. I'll just, first of all, I will write the script and then I will show you what is in there. So I'll just copy it from here. Let me clear the screen. So I'm running it in bash. Then this script prints a message about your weight if you give it to your weight in kilos and height in centimeter. So here we'll be giving the argument for weight, which is for $1, which will be taken as $1, and height $2 out. And then it will be calculating ideal weight, which is height, dollar height, the value which will be given in here, minus 100. And if dollar weight is less than equal to ideal weight, then you should eat a bit more fat, else you should eat a bit more fruit. So let me run the script. And give the value as, let me say, the weight as 52 and the height as 70. So what it is doing, ideal weight is 72 minus 100, means height minus 100. So $1 is for weight and $2 is for height. So height is 72 minus 100, means it's in minus, so it's lesser than the ideal weight. So the output came like this. And in here, if you give it as 170, so you should eat a bit more fat. Now, one thing you should notice in here, that nowhere it is mentioned that how many arguments we should be given to this value. So if you give here some other values also like this, the script will be executed. There's no change in the script, in the output. It will be taking these two values only. But why should we do like this? Let us modify the script and let us put something which will show you, means which will instruct that only two arguments only can be given as an input. So let us edit the file and give this in here. I will show you. So what it is doing is, if the argument is not equals to 2, then it will give the output as usage $0, which will be taking this weight.sh output, weight in kilos, length in centimeters, like this one output will be displayed, and then it will be exiting from the script. It won't be executing these values. So let me try it once. In here I have more than two arguments present, and you can see the output is coming as usage is weight in kilos, length in centimeter, $0, weight in kilos, length in centimeter. Now let me give the values, these two values only, to see whether the script is really working or not. Yes, it is working, and I'm taking the output in here. So I believe you have understood till now what all we have covered. One more thing, till now what all we saw those were very, very simple. We also have the if statements can be much more complicated with elif clauses. So if, else, elif, like that, consequent, many blocks might be there. So let us try this with a simple example. Well, let me get first write it, and then from here I will explain it to you. So it will be testing the disk space. So what it is doing, my space value is given as df hyphen h, then it is taken, and if I'm setting the alert value as 85, so if space value is greater than alert value, then alert one of my disk is nearly full, or else this space is normal. This is not an elif clause, but we are just seeing some more examples. So here, if you jot this, what will be the output for this? 68. How come it is coming 68? Let us take, as I told you, if you are not able to debug something, just go step by step. The first step is df-h. So it is giving the output like this, and here I'm taking the fifth column. So what is the fifth column? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So use percentage will be coming as a fifth column. Now from there I need to grep only the lines having percentage in it. So it is displaying like this. Next, I need to remove this use. How do I do it? Grep hyphen v. This all we already covered in our previous session. Next, what I need to do is I need to sort it in ascending order. So after sorting in ascending order, I need to take the output, my last output in here. Now I need to cut the percentage from here. So this gives the output. So if I run this, space value is 68, which is lesser than alert value, which is 85. So my output should be, this space is normal. So first of all, give execute permission into this and run the statement. So this space is normal. Now let me edit it and give the alert value as, let's say, 55, or let it be as 5 itself, and run it. Alert, one of my disk is nearly full. We are getting the output. Next comes nested if clauses, where we have our elif statements. This will be with leap year. We are seeing one example. Let me clear the screen first and paste it in there. So in here, what it is doing, we are calculating leap year. So date plus percentage y, if you give the output, it will be given just the year value in here. So if your year is divisible by 400 is equal to 0, then it should be a leap year. Else if it will be going ahead with another clause, your year is divisible by 4 is also equal to 0, then means the remainder is 0, then if your year is also is divisible by 100, but it is not the there is some remainder value in there, then this is a leap year, else this is not a leap year. So let me run this. So this is a leap year, it has 29 days. So let me check the script whether it is really it is running or not. I am just bluffing in here. I'll give the value in here as 2021. Hope everything is fine, is 2021, and I will run. So this is not a leap year, February has 28 days. Next, let us go to our using exit numbers with if clauses. So let me write this. So what it is doing is, we are giving the menu two arguments in here. One is for menu, another one is for an animal. So if menu is fish, then if animal is penguin, then things will be happy. Then this output will be coming. If let us run this now. So things. And let me give the output as menu as fish and animal as penguin. So the output should be fish. Things happy. Now, else if animal is dolphin and menu is fish, it's okay for fins. This is the output. Else, yuck. Yuck, things don't like it. Now, if let so this is done, means when I'm giving the argument for fish. So if you just give penguin like this, else exit 3, it will come in as this. So what is our value for echo dollar 0 right now? We are embedding the echo dollar 0 output as 3. Sorry, echo dollar question mark. Well, my bad. I need to run this. Now let me see. See why it came as 0 at first, because the earlier command was echo dollar 0, which gave the output. So it came as 0. And one more thing you need to see, that if menu is fish and else, let me run this. So my menu is not fish, my menu is something like this, and my animal is penguin. So it will give the output as Finks don't like that, Finks wants fish. So right now my encode this one will be exit one. Next, let us go to our document, and here comes the case statement. This case statement is very much similar to our if statements, but in here it will be, we are taking the same disk test output. We are taking the similar disk test dot sh script, where this is the output for space, for variable space we are taking this output, and in case we are writing case if dollar space is in 1 to 6, then percentage means from 10 to 69, then this space is well below threshold. If it is between 70 to 89, then please do some housekeeping. There's like this percentage. If it is between 91 to 98, order for a new disk. If it is 99, alert. And if it start, then it is 100% full. Then we are giving the end clause, as I told you earlier. For if it is FI to end the if statement, for case it is the opposite, CAAC to ASAC. We'll be discussing this in details in our, while we are going ahead with the scripts and all. So I'll be concluding the session today in here itself. We'll be meeting in the next session, where we'll be seeing about display user messages and some more things. So thanks a lot for watching the video. I hope you like my session. Please do subscribe, share, like, and comment. Thank you.